Thank you for having me. My name is Shandika Moitra and I am going to be speaking to you today about our final year project.
Okay. In your PPT, under the supervision of submitted by
guide name kuch hai. Who is your supervision?
Under the supervision of ঠিক আছে কলো কন্টিনিউ কর
ওকে স্যার so thank you for having me. My name is Shandika Moitra and I am going to speak today about our final year project on species distribution modeling. Our group members are Bishal Das, Joyprasad Sharma, Subhashish Kaur, Devarghya Ganguly, Arup Kumar Mondal and
One minute, Shandika, what is your title of the project? Is it title of the project?
No, sir. Title of the project is species distribution modeling.
So why have you not updated this in the PPT, first slide?
We have done that in second page, sir, actually.
That should not be done.
Second page,
don't you know how to prepare PPT? You are presenting in your final semester, final year project. You have not written your supervisor name. You have not written project name in the title slide. Have you really contacted with your supervisor?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir. We have contacted.
So.
প্রজেক্ট রিভিউ রিপোর্ট একটা সাবমিট করতে হবে। image pixel is 30 meter per pixel, and Sentinel 2, we taken the picture resolution is 10 meter per pixel.
Auto?
Yes, sir.
Just full screen color data.
Deva go.
Presentation full screen color.
Upore.
Upore kya konda?
আচ্ছা আমি
দেখো ফুল স্ক্রিন এই তো নিচে গিয়ে করো না নিচে দেখো কাপের মধ্যে একটা সাইন আছে ডান দিকে এখানে পার্সেন্টেজটা লেখা রয়েছে তার পাশে হ্যাঁ 10% টা পার্সেন্টেজ জাস্ট পাশে হ্যাঁ ক্লিক করো
হয়েছে ফুল স্ক্রিন দেখতে ওখানে দেখা যাচ্ছে স্যার
না এখানে
এবার
না
স্যার আমারটা ফুল স্ক্রিন দেখাচ্ছে এখন মানে
তোমারটা ফুল স্ক্রিন দেখাচ্ছে তাহলে নেটওয়ার্ক প্রবলেম হয়েছে আপডেটটা হচ্ছে না প্রেজেন্টেশনের শুরুতেই তো এটা করে নেবে না এটা ফুল স্ক্রিন করে প্রেজেন্টেশন করবে এভাবে কেউ ইয়ে করে নাকি ওকে ঠিক আছে কন্টিনিউ করো হ্যাঁ এবার আসছে
এটা আমার স্ক্রিন
অরূপ হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে
স্যার ফুল স্ক্রিন
হ্যাঁ 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 এবার ঠিক আছে
ওকে স্যার ওকে
এবার ঠিক আছে ওকে ওকে কন্টিনিউ অরূপ
ইয়েস স্যার Okay, there is the picture resolution for Landsat 8 data is 30 meter per pixel and Sentinel data is 2 Sentinel 2A data is 10 meter per second per pixel. Next slide. There were.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes.
Good afternoon, all of all my respected teachers and my dear friends. Thank you for giving me the wonderful opportunity to share some of the information about our project, which is partially done till now. So. This is the slide where I tell about the difference between the object-based classification and pixel-based classification.
So, little bit louder, Devargo, and text is not justified.
Yes. Hello, ma'am. Am I audible now?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. So, pixel-based classification is actually where the classification is done per pixel level. We have to use every pixel and have to classify it. And we got the result. And why we use the spectral information also? Like individually, we have to calculate the pixels, value of the pixels, which where the locality are ignored. And in this sense, every pixel represents one training example for a classification algorithm. Which particular algorithm we will choose depend on us. Like it may be the supervised or unsupervised classification algorithms, like random forest, CART, or if unsupervised, then k-means clustering. Anything can be used, but the training example would be in the form of an n-dimensional vector. It will depend on our work, and where n was the number of the spectral bands in the image data. There are several bands which indicate the small details of the classification region of the region. Here we worked on the Lothian Island, and accordingly the trained classification algorithm would give us the output of the class prediction for individual pixel. So here we will get the better result in Sentinel 2A data source. And the only reason is that in the Sentinel 2A, the pixel is less, that is 10 meters per pixel. Therefore, we got the better result than Landsat. Because lens, in Landsat, there is 30 meters per pixel. So for pixel-based classification, I can tell by observing our result that Sentinel-2A is much better than Landsat. Now, I am coming on the object-based classification. Object-based classification is done by localizing some group of pixels. It is quite different from the pixel-based classification. And when we're taking into the account the spatial properties of each pixel, they are related to each other. Some relations can be found on each of them. And by relating them, we will get the result on our classification. Actually, a training example for a classification algorithm would consist of a group of pixels. Whereas in the pixel-based classification, we will individually calculate each and every pixel and will get the result on basis of that. For example, in the object-based classification, for a crude example, an image might be partitioned into n segments of equal size. They can be break down. And after that, each segment would give a class which contain an object or may not contain an object, but we will get the result on the basis of that. So this is the primary and the basic difference between the pixel-based classification and object-based classification. Now I am going to the next slide. So here in this slide, I will tell that why mangrove is important and why classification is important to signify about the growth or the reduction of mangrove in the recent years. Because we all know that after many storms, cyclonic storms, floods, many mangrove plantations are destroyed in the regions like Sundarban, Andaman, in this type of regions. So what is the importance of mangrove? We all know mangroves are one of the most important ecosystems of coastal and marine areas. And mangrove also safeguards us, the ecology of the coastal areas like fishermen, pastoral families. And also, if we notice, we can identify and signify that only due to the mangrove, our West Bengal got avoided from the main devastating part of the storm. The mangrove saves us from that side. And mangrove plantation also serves the coastal serves as a barrier to cyclones, the point I have told just now, and tsunamis, and protects the people living in the coastal areas. Mangrove also acts as a buffer zone between the land and the sea, and protect the land from the erosion and play an invaluable role as nature shield against the cyclones, ecological disasters, protected shorelines, and many more. So from time to time, a huge change can be noticed due to the destruction of the mangroves in these particular regions. And now I am coming why classification is important to signify where the mangrove is now and what is the amount of the growth or the reduction comparing to the past and what may be the amount of the mangrove in the future. And if we can do this by our classification, that is our satisfaction because we are now dealing with this. So classification is important in this scenario to identify the mangrove region including other regions associated with it like water bodies, urban region and other small plants. And by classifying two different techniques, there are two techniques of mainly classification. There are primarily two techniques, supervised and unsupervised. We can compare with one another that whose result is more accurate and whose accuracy result we got, and we can compare there. And this is the best one for our purpose to solve. So now, this is the image type classification algorithms result and accuracy. This will be continued by our another group member, Vishal Das. So Vishal, if you please continue.
Good morning, sir. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to represent my part. I am continuing from this. Okay. After classification, we are working on the Lothian Island from Sundarban, and we are working with the Landsat 8 and Sentinel 2A data set. And we are performing the random forest and card classification from both of the data sets. So after classification, we have got testing accuracy on card on Landsat data in one, and the validation accuracy in 99.38%. Similarly, in Sentinel 2A of card, we have got the testing accuracy of one and the validation accuracy of 99.94%. And the Landsat random forest of Landsat 8, we have got the testing accuracy of 99.96%, as well as we have got the validation accuracy of 99.58% on the Lothian Island, obviously. And of the Sentinel-2A random forest, we have got the testing accuracy of 1 and the validation accuracy of 99.94%. next slide. Okay, this is the first part of the classification of us. It is a Landsat random forest. We have applied the random forest on Landsat 8 data. We have got the confusion matrix of the Landsat 8 confusion matrix of the classification, which is shown here, and the accuracy validation accuracy we have got is 99.35%. Next slide. This is the picture of the classification on Landsat 8, and we have worked the CART classification on it. And the error confusion matrix of it is as shown as this picture, and the validation accuracy we have got is 98.89%. Next slide. Okay, this is this picture is for Sentinel 2A dataset, and we have applied the random forest on it. The confusion matrix is this confusion matrix, and we have got the validation accuracy of 99.81%. Next slide. Okay, this is the last classification for Sentinel 2A, and we have applied CART classification for this. Confusion matrix is it is shown, and the validation accuracy is 99.81%. Next slide. Okay, we have applied several indices apart from the bands, which are presented in the dataset. This this index is NDVI, which is normalized difference vegetation index. It is shown as a vegetation amount and the distribution of the vegetation in the particular area or the particular region we are working on. The value of the NDVI is calculated with the NIR band, near infrared band, and the red band, red channel band of that image, particular image. The formula is NIR minus red, or near infrared minus red, divided by near infrared plus red. And the value of the NDVI differs from the -1 to 1. Next slide. You see, Cassell-Clark transformation. It is also used for vegetation mapping. And is, apart from vegetation mapping, we can observe the brightness, greenness, and wetness. What is brightness? Brightness is used to classify the area, which is the area which is non-vegetated actually, which are from urban area or the vegetated or sand area. We can distinguish from it from the vegetated area using the brightness band of the TC, tasseled cap. And the wetness, greenness index is used to classify or predict the vegetation part apart from the non-vegetated part. And the wetness part is used to the wetness area or the water body areas. So that we can determine or predict the water body areas from the other non-vegetated or vegetated or urban areas. The formula is as shown below. Next, NDMI. NDMI is another kind of index. The full form is normalized difference moisture index. We can also define the index as shortwave infrared and the green band. Formula is the shortwave infrared minus green divided by shortwave infrared plus green. This band is also differ from the -1 to 1, and using this band we can determine the where the moisture value determines actually. Next slide. Okay. In this classification, we have used the mangrove. We have used the classification which is mangrove, non-mangrove, water, mangrove, non-mangrove, non-vegetation, and water. Mangrove means on the particular Luthien island, where the mangrove we can get from the particular data set, we have predicted that. And a non-mangrove is the apart from the mangrove, but the vegetated area. This is the non-mangrove area. No vegetation means the sand area or the vegetation that does not occur on the particular place. And the water is the water body area outside the land area. We have performed the four classified areas, and using the Landsat 8 and Sentinel 2A both, we're using the random forest and CART classification. Next slide. Okay. Before classifying the data set, we are performing the data analysis part for both data set, Landsat 8 and Sentinel 2 also. From the Landsat 8 part, we have got the first chart, which is shown as a band versus reflectance chart of a particular for the particular to the four classes we have used. And you can see the first B1, B2, B3 and B4, the values does not differ because the B2, B4, B3, B4 represent the green, blue, green and red bands. But the B5 band is a near infrared band. It differs from the vegetated and the water and the non-vegetated area. And the and you can see the brightness, greenness and wetness band from the TC band and the NDVI band as shown. And the NDVI, from the NDVI band, we can actually represent the vegetated areas, actually classify the vegetated areas or separate the vegetated areas. For the water, in water part, the NDVI value is less than zero. And the and the after that the non-mangrove water, non-mangrove, mangrove and no vegetation part, the value is greater than zero. From that, the NDVI value of the mangrove is most greater than everywhere. Similarly, for the Sentinel 2A part, it is shown the graph from the for the bands versus reflectance. Okay, next. This is the time series plot for Sentinel 2 and Landsat both. Time series series plots is we have actually taken the date from the for Landsat to 2017 to 2021 for December, and that we have distributed only NDVI value which is distributed from the 2017 to 2021 how it is varies from that time for Landsat 8 and Sentinel both. The top image is representing the Sentinel 2A image and the bottom image is representing the Landsat 8 image. Okay. Next. Okay, Aru.
Sentinel, we are doing all the classification and observing the all the graph. We get that Sentinel 2 is the better than Landsat 8 data. So here for Sentinel data we are getting 10 meter per pixel data, which is more than a clear from Landsat 8 data. So we are and Landsat 8 is 30 meter per pixel data, which is less accurate than the Landsat 2 data. So next it is conclusion, Devargo.
So now this is our project up till now, and we will complete it within some days, the full completion of the project. So now in today's presentation, this is to conclude that Sentinel 2A data source gives more accurate result in classifying mangrove than Landsat 8 data source. But this is not the end. We will deal also with other data sources like SAR, JAXA, and we will do other new types of classification, hyperspectral classification, and many object-based classification after this. So in near future, we will deal with the other data sources also, and we will notice which data source is best for classification of the mangrove region. Thank you to all our respective teachers, and that's all.
Okay. প্রজেক্ট ওভারঅল ঠিক আছে, কিন্তু বাট ফ্লাইট রেডি বা ডকুমেন্টস এই ব্যাপারগুলোতে তোমাদের নেগলিজেন্স অনেকটাই বেশি। তো যাই হোক, ডকুমেন্টসটা প্রিপেয়ার করে অবশ্যই মেল আইডি, যেটা প্রথম মেল আইডি পাঠানো হয়েছিল সেখানেই পাঠাবে, ঠিক আছে?
ওকে স্যার, ওকে স্যার, আমরা আজকের মধ্যে
ডকুমেন্টটা আজকেই আপলোড করে দেব।
আপলোড করার না, মেল করে দেব।
আজকেই করে দেব।
ঠিক আছে, বাকিদের কারো কি কোনো কোশ্চেন আছে? পিয়ার স্যার বা কেউ কিছু কোশ্চেন করবেন? শিবাশিস স্যার,
না আমার দিক থেকে নেই।
ঠিক আছে তাহলে এদেরকে লিড করতে বলি
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ লিড করতে বলো
তোমরা তাহলে লিড করে যাও ঠিক আছে
ওকে স্যার
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার
থ্যাংক ইউ সবাইকে একবার অ্যাড করে কথা বলে নিবি